Hello astronomers! One of the most interesting trends in modern astrophotography is the growing adoption of strainwave mounts, especially for portable imaging setups. So today I want to show you how I actually use the SkyWatcher Wave 150i strainwave mount with my astrophotography system. Let's get started! Strainwave mounts offer a key advantage compared to mounts based on worm gear transmission, since they deliver high torque in a very compact and lightweight mechanical design. In many configurations, especially when using compact and lightweight refractors, they allow imaging even without counterweights. This is one of the main reasons why strainwave mounts are becoming so popular for portable astrophotography setups. If portability is the clear advantage of this solution, on the other hand, strainwave mounts typically show higher and more complex periodic error behavior. This usually means that for deep sky astrophotography, guiding is always required and must be tuned carefully to achieve the best results. Portability is the main reason why I'm using the SkyWatcher Wave 150i strainwave mount with my Takahashi FSQ85. And Atik APX26 camera. This is a portable wide-field astrophotography setup that, together with the Esato 3 inches focuser, Arco 3 inches rotator, Giotto flat field generator, Alto cover motor, Eagle computer and the guide scope, weighs about 12 kilos. This means that I can use this setup without a counterweight, since the SkyWatcher Wave 150i payload capacity without counterweight is 15 kilos. If instead I use a larger telescope, like this SkyWatcher Esprit 100ADX, which together with all our devices like Eagle, Esato, Arco and others weighs 15 kilos, I simply add the optional counterweight to the mount and I'm ready to go. Now, let's look at the practical side. How do I actually use and control the SkyWatcher Wave 150i strainwave mount in this setup? First of all, on the mount control panel, you find a USB Type-B port to connect the mount to a computer and a 12V power port 5.5 2.1mm to power the mount. I use a standard USB cable to connect the mount to the Eagle, and an Eagle-type power cable connected to one of the 8 amps power ports of the Eagle. In this way, I can power the mount directly from Eagle, avoiding the need for an external power unit. On the Eagle, I start the SceneScan app, which essentially works like a virtual handpad and provides configuration and connectivity to the mount. Then I launch Play, and I connect to the mount using its ASCOM driver. At this point, the mount becomes fully integrated into the imaging workflow, together with all the other devices I control through Play. For more content that will help you to explore the universe like a pro, subscribe to our channel and clear skies!